Okay, we're going to do the configuration for an extruder, a fan, and a fan. This is pretty simple and it'll be pretty quick, hopefully. So the extruder is going to go in D10. So you're going to connect the first side over here. You're then going to screw it down. Then the other side, so plus and minus in this case do not matter. Now we're going to do the fan, and because we have a positive and negative wire, we're going to do the negative first. This is going to go in D9 on the negative side, and then the positive side. And then for the other fan, we're going to do exactly the same. And this is going to go into D8. On the positive side, into D8. And in the next portion of the video, I'll show you how to actually configure it in the Marlin driver, but with the extruder, you still have to put this in T0, which are the two pins over here. And just a moment, I'll show you how to load it with the firmware. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin folder, we're going to open up Marlin folder and go to marlin.ino. Going to open that up. We're going to go to the configuration.h tab. We're going to search on motherboard. Now, currently it's set up for the extruder, the fan, and the bed. So we're going to change that to EFF for extruder, fan, fan. Then we're going to scroll down to find the thermistor settings. Here we go, thermal settings. And the thermistor that I currently am using is this one, which is number 8. So we're going to scroll down, and down here we have a bunch of choices. We're only using one sensor, so we're going to say that it's number 8. Now we don't have another thermistor, so we don't have to worry about this one or any of these, and we don't have a heat bed, so we're good there. Now let's check to make sure that we have our temperature safeguards enabled. Okay, for a thermal runaway, it appears that we have both of them enabled. Technically, in this case, we don't need the bed, but we'll just leave it alone. So we're going to connect our USB cable so we can actually upgrade. So you connect the serial cable to your Adreno 2560. The other end will go into the computer. And we'll check to see if it's enabled. Looks like we're on COM6 and we've got the right board. So all we have to do is compile and upload. In the next portion, I'll show you in Pronterface how it's actually connected. Okay, we're gonna plug in the power supply. And then we're going to plug it into the socket
with the power supply power.
Okay, in the Pronterface folder, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the device. Now, in other videos, I've shown how to turn on the fan. So, this is how it's done. You type M106 and enter, and that will enable one of your fans. I have another video that you can reference for dual fans that'll give you more detail on that. But let me just show you the extruder here. I've cranked down the temperature for safety's sake. All I need to do to turn that on is press set, and that'll give a peak of 75 degrees Celsius. And then down below, this blue line that's rising shows it heating up to temp. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.